Hey, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to quickly create the look of a neon sign. I provided this image of a brick wall that you could download, as well as the font I'm using. Feel free to use whatever font you like, just make sure it's a relatively thick font. Their links are in my video's description or project files. Before we begin, if you want to know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials, smash that subscribe button, and please remember to click like if you like this video. Thank you. Open your horizontal type tool. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. We'll invert the colors by pressing X or by clicking this icon. White should be our foreground color so we can see it easily on the brick wall. Open your type picker and pick a font. I'll make its size 544 points based on the font I'm using and the number of characters in my text. Once you type out your text, feel free to adjust its size. Make the aliasing smooth and center alignment. Click on your document and type out your text. To center it, open your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command A to select your document and click the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. Then deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. For this example, let's skew our text. To do this, press Ctrl or Command T to open our Transform tool and go to the middle of one of the sides of the bounding box. Press and hold Ctrl-Alt-Shift on Windows or Command-Option-Shift on a Mac as you drag it up or down to an angle you like. Then press Enter or Return. Ctrl-click or Command-click the large T of the text layer to select our text's shape. Go to Select and Save Selection. Click OK and press Ctrl or Command-D to deselect it. Next, we'll darken the brick wall background. Make the background active and click the adjustment layer icon. Click Levels. In the white output field, type in 91. Make your text layer active and right-click or secondary click an empty area of the layer to open the flyout list. Click Rasterize Type. Ctrl-click or Command-click the thumbnail of your text to select your text shape. Go to Select, Modify, and Contract. Contract it 20 pixels. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Go back to Select, Modify, and Smooth. Smooth it 10 pixels. Press the Delete key on your keyboard to delete everything inside the selection, then deselect it. Double-click an empty area of your text layer to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay and the Color Box. In the hexadecimal field, I'll type in 6EAAFB. However, feel free to pick another color that has similar color saturation and brightness. The blend mode is normal and the opacity is 100%. Click Outer Glow and the color box. I'll type in 1176FF, but if you're using a different color, pick a color richer and darker than the one you picked earlier. The blend mode is normal, the opacity is 100%, and the noise is 0. The technique is softer, the spread is 0, and the size is 20 pixels. The contour is linear, and the range is 50%. Click Drop Shadow. The color is black, the blend mode is multiply, and the opacity is 100%. The angle is 120 degrees, the distance is 15 pixels, the spread is 0, and the size is 20 pixels. Control or Command click the thumbnail of the text to select its shape. Go to Select, modify, and contract. Contract at 6 pixels. Go back to select, modify, and feather. Feather it 2 pixels. We'll fill it with white, but before we do, make a new layer. Since our foreground color is white, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Then deselect it. We'll convert our text into a smart object so we can add a blur to it overall. To do this, Shift-click the Neon Tubes layer to make it active as well, and click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel. Click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 1 pixel. Next, we'll create a glow on the wall. We'll make a new layer below the active layer by Control or Command clicking the New Layer icon. Control or Command click the thumbnail of the neon text to select its shape. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather it 20 pixels. Click the foreground color. I'll type in 4CA9FF, which is close to the color of my neon tubes. Fill the selection with the color by pressing Alt or Option plus Delete. Then deselect it. Make a new layer under the active layer and open your Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Control or Command click the thumbnail of Alpha 1 to select its shape and open back the Layers panel. Go to Select. In versions earlier than CC 2015.5, click Refine Edge. In later versions, click Select and Mask. Feather it 200 pixels and shift the edge 20%. Output it to a selection. Fill it with the foreground color and deselect it. Change its blend mode to Vivid Light and make a copy of it. Change its blend mode to Color Dodge and reduce its opacity to 50%. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.